So, hey, let's sing together This Little Light of Mine. Ready? This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Hide it under a bushel. Hide it under a bushel. No, I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel. No, I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel. No, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Don't you go and blow it out. Don't you go and whip it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Don't you go and blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Don't you go and whip it out. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Gonna take my light around the world. I'm gonna let it shine. Gonna take my light around the world. I'm gonna let it shine. Gonna take my light around the world. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Everywhere I go, everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
And so you're going to hear me to say sing and then pray and clap and shout and smile and laugh and all those things. So feel free to do all those things and sing along, dance along. While you're at it. So here's Sing When the Spirit Says Sing. Sing along and clap along and laugh along. Look forward to seeing all of you guys again sometime soon when we can get together and worship and sing together and safely. So take care of yourselves and God bless.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the season of Lent. It's so good to have you with us this morning, and I hope you enjoyed our opening songs. My name is Mary Soularud. I'm glad to be back with you. I am here as staff at the cathedral, and I'm also canon for Congregational Vitality for the Diocese of Maryland. And I'm your worship leader for Lent. Let us begin with our words of welcome to God in our lives. Let us love God with our hearts and our neighbors as ourselves. Let us love God with our minds and our neighbors as ourselves. Let us love God with our strength and our neighbors as ourselves. This is a reading from the book of Genesis. God said to Noah and his sons with him, "As for me, I am establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the domestic animals, and every animal of the earth with you, as many as came out of the ark. I establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of a flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." God said, "This is a sign of the covenant that I make between me and you and every living creature that is with you for all future generations. I have set my bow in the clouds, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow is seen in the clouds, I will remember my covenant that is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh. And the water shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. When the bow is in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is on the earth." God said to Noah, "This is the sign of the covenant that I have established between me and all flesh that is on the earth." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. That story comes at the end of a story that many of us know about a great flood that covered the world. And Noah took animals of every kind, two of them, put them on this huge boat called an ark, and he and his family rode the waters of the flood with all the animals until one day the rain stopped and the waters ebbed away, and they came out of the ark, and in the sky was an enormous rainbow. That's the bow that is talked about in that reading, a rainbow. And it is a sign of God's promise. The promise that we heard today is that God said, "I love all the creatures of the earth and all the people of the earth so much that there will never be a flood that ever destroys everything ever again." That's a promise that God makes with all creation, with all people. I suspect that all of us know about promises. I made promises when I got married. My parents and my godparents made promises to God on my behalf when I was baptized. When I was ordained a priest, I made some more promises. And each time I made those promises to God and to the people I served. Promises are really important in our life as God's beloved children, as God's beloved people. But more important than any promise I make or any promise you might make is the promise God makes to us. God makes one promise over and over and over and over again. And Lent, that season of preparation for the resurrection of Jesus, is a time for us to remember God's promises. God's most important promise to us is that we are beloved, and that when we don't follow God and we're sorry, God forgives us because God loves us. Over and over and over again in Lent, we will hear stories about how it is that God promises to love us no matter what. What an incredible promise. So my invitation to you during this season of preparation is that you think about a promise you might make to love God, to love your family, to love your friends, and to love even people you don't know. Love them as God loves them, because that's the promise God makes. And if it doesn't always work out, come back to God who loves us. Say you're sorry and love, love, love again, because God loves us. It's the best promise God ever made, and God makes it every day to each of us. Amen. And now we'll sing the song, Jesus, We Are Here.
Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. We are here, here for you. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. We are here, here for you.
Here are our prayers today. Made alive in Christ and filled with the Holy Spirit, let us pray for the church, the world, and all of God's creation. And I invite you to say, hear our prayer. Holy God, in the risen Jesus, you are always with us, loving us as only you can. As your church, help us to bring your love to all those we meet in any way. Loving God, hear our prayer. All people are your children. May the leaders of all nations bring justice and peace to the people of the world. Loving God, hear our prayer. Creator God, you give us all that is beautiful on earth, in the air and in the seas. Bless all of your creatures, wild and tame. Loving God, hear our prayer. You are always with us. Now we pray for all those who need your healing grace in their lives. Please pray for those who are sick or need our prayers. Loving God, hear our prayer. Giver of love and mercy, we thank you for the gifts you give us each day. Please pray for things for which you are grateful. Loving God, hear our prayer. Eternal God, we remember all those whom we love, those who have formed us, and those who are no longer with us. Please pray for those who have died. Loving God, hear our prayer. And now we'll sing again, Jesus, we are here.
Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. We are here, here for you. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. We are here, here for you.
Let us pray together in the words Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May God bless you and keep you today and always. And at every meal, may you be fed with God's justice and peace, that you may do God's work in the world. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. And now we'll have a closing song.
Ready? One, two, three. In the old and